again, boys and girls. Today is April 23rd, 2020, and it's our 23rd day of e-learning. You've been home for 23 days learning with your families. When you move your pointer to the top, today is Thumbs Up Thursday all day long. Mwah! To you at home. So this week we're talking about clothes, and we're talking about what people wear and why. So different professions or different cultures, or even in different seasons. You might wear different clothes for different seasons. So in the spring, you might wear something like what I'm wearing here, a long sleeve shirt to keep you warm. You don't really need quite a winter coat that you would wear, like I said, in the winter. You also have the summer. Likely I would be in short sleeves in the summer. And then you have the fall. And that's probably about what you're gonna wear, like what you wear in the spring a lot of times, like a long sleeve light shirt or jacket. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at my clothes. I have a bunch of clothes on my clothesline, and we're going to figure out where they would be sorted or where we would put a tally. We're just gonna tally today. So I'm gonna make two different tally marks on two different graphs. So over here, these are the clothes that we're gonna be looking at. We're gonna look at them to determine if they've got patterns, numbers or letters on them, or if they're a solid color. Like my white shirt is a solid white. And over here on this side, we're gonna make tallies in these spaces here. If a piece of clothing is soft or fuzzy, if it's slippery, or if it's thick. And that you can tell by touching. So let's start over here with our eyes. Let's see if we can find patterns, numbers or letters, or solid colors. All right, so over here, looks like we have something. It has some letters on it. Tavistock, that's where I swim. So I'm gonna put a little tally mark under numbers or letters. Over here, this looks like it's patterned. Again, I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna put a little tally mark. This shirt here is a solid. When I look at it, it has no patterns, it has no numbers, no letters. So I'm gonna come over here and give a tally mark where it says solid. Oh, I see some numbers and a big P for Phillies. Stick a little line right on here where it says numbers or letters. Aha, what's this? Avon School. I see some letters. Another tally. All right, this here, looks like down here it's got patterns, the patterns with the flowers. So we're gonna come over here and put another tally on patterns. All right, this one here, what do you think? Maybe a solid? I guess we'd call that solid. It's solid straight through. Let's give that a little tally mark. Tally there. I would say that the stripes are a pattern because it's going gray, black, and then it breaks it up in the middle, and then we get back to a pattern again over here. So let's go over here and put a little check mark for patterns. All right, how about this one? Patterns again. We've got some more stripes. Tally. This one here, that one's a tough one. I guess we could call that patterns because there's stars on it. So let's give another tally. Now remember, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. We're gonna put a line this way to make it 5. So now we have 5 so far, that's the winner. All right, let's look over here. We're gonna put these over there for now. That happens to be snowballs and brews, please. I'll take a picture of them there and let you see it later. All right, I would say that's just a solid jean. So that's gonna be a little tally here, a solid. This here, the pajamas, they're patterned. So we're gonna give a little mark, another line over here. This one here, patterned sharks on our bathing suits. So up, and here's another pattern on another bathing suit. So I'm gonna put two more tallies under patterns. 1, 2. Oh, over here, look at that. If you look up here, this is my Cub Scout group, my son. You can see some numbers and letters. So we're gonna put another mark right there. And then, Phillies again, more letters and numbers, and then same for our S-Jack swimming, letters and numbers. Two more for our letters and numbers, one and then another one there. All right, so let's look at the first mark of tallies we did when we looked at our articles of clothing. Over here we have 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 for the patterns, 5 plus one more makes 6. 6 for the numbers or letters. And the solid colors, 1, 2, 3. So let's look. What number is the biggest? Which one has the most? The patterns, they are the most. Which one has the least? The number 3 is the smallest number of the solid colors, has the least. All right, let's do the same.